Well, this is the 5th of May, another day in the life of Alan. Today has been very, very hot again, but I am not complaining. But it's been a day, I will say, where if any day I can see the momentum gathering, it's been today. Because today has been non-stop with people who are wanting to converse. I have found that in this shopping mall there are so many people that have worked in England or are still working there that are coming home to visit family, and then they're presenting themselves and we're having conversation. Today has been non-stop. There's been a lot of people put a lot of interesting questions, and I've also made friends with a lot of people. I mean, there was one young lady, as Craig's looking at me now, he can probably focus on what I've been painting because I'll still continue to talk. Let's just quickly go to this image here. Now, this is what I've been painting today in between the PR that I do. This is a lad who's had his image for a few months now, but I completed it this afternoon. And again, I had a French painter with me who goes back a long way. His name is Corbet. I cannot for the life of me think of his first name, but I do know this. At the age of 15, he was the one who was with me when I did my first oil painting. I was aware at that age, and it was a painting that looked far beyond the years of a 15-year-old lad. So he was here today, and he has been before to me on different occasions. But no sooner than I'd finished this painting, around 2:30, than the lad himself turns up. Now, I haven't seen him for 2 or 3 months, but I can assure you there's jungle drums in Banská Bystrica. They just turn up. Because no sooner, if we just go to this image here, which we take a look at this young girl, quite an attractive girl. She's got hair that really comes down to her waist. She's probably no more than 14, but no sooner than I'd put her on the canvas than she turns up with one of her other friends who's going on probably next. So I can only imagine that they're all texting one another when they begin to appear on the canvas. But it's this sort of momentum that is around the painting. It's quite incredible. I've just lost count of the different ones who've stopped to speak. There was a lady who's from Banská, who's living in Cyprus, and she could speak good English, and she was here quite a while. There was another young lady who, when guessing her age, I thought she was 26 or 7, then said she was 37, but she'd worked for 2 years in Bournemouth, and again could speak good English. But she got a young child, and she said, could she go on the picture? Well, I'm just now accepting that so many of these situations are meant to be. In fact, today we've had at least 7 more images that I've said yes, not in a way that's pacifying people, but when I see their eyes and the passion that these people are wanting their children in this painting, it's just impossible to refuse. I mean, standing behind us now, we're going to turn the camera on these young lads. These three lads here. These three lads. He's going to be painting very soon on the painting. The lad who's got the Mohican haircut and is always sticking his tongue out. He's going to go on too. So these are some of the visitors. So again, there's a momentum. But I like the gear. I like the hat. And so this is what's around the painting. So anyway, we'll turn round to the painting. So, I'm still here, still talking. This is the momentum with people. And probably, and this is what I believe now, as I said yesterday, I did a count, there's over 48 young people, children from Slovakia on here, mostly from Banská. There's gonna be the same amount, if not more, by the time it's finished. And there's a remarkable thing as well that's happening. I have got this line, this invisible line that goes across the bottom of the painting, where I know, as I've said before, I've got to put some very important images onto the canvas. And yet, with all these children that keep coming, I'm finding space above this particular invisible line of 3'6" to 4'. So again, I'm just painting what I feel. The two of the girls who turned up, I showed them drawings I've done, and we will be putting the drawings up with captions, with some symbols of Banska in the background as to what will go on postcards. So this is another message I shall start showing in what's happening. So today, well, it's been pretty unbearable in here with heat, but on the other side, the momentum and the people that are wanting just to talk and relate to the picture is becoming quite significant. We're just going to stop the camera for a moment and we'll just have a look at the images from these children from Banska Bystrica that grows every day. What I say is, every time we take a photograph of someone, we probably on the night get the scanning machine going and then we introduce them the following day. So just on that alone, there's still another 20 or more to be painted with those that keep coming every day. So again, my time slot for finishing this painting seems to be moving all the time. I've just said to Craig, just to put these children in is going to take me till the end of May, and I still haven't gone to the bottom part, which is going to be the most important relating to the message that the painting conveys. But still, I'm happy with the way things are going, and each day proves that what has been done is correct. With that, we'll take one last big shot of the full canvas. Well, we're looking at the picture now as a full snapshot. The painting has different feelings for different people. But a couple of things that were said to me today, which obviously strike a light. One of the lads who I painted with, his young lady, he's about 17, came with his mother today, but she also brought the rest of the family. And she wanted to be on the painting. And I couldn't say, well, it's for children, because really, she got the look, and not in a bad way, but she got the look of a child. She was quite attractive and still looked very young. And rather than say no to her, because again, she seemed so passionate that she wanted to be in the painting. And so we took a photograph, and she will not be noticed as anyone older than what's in the painting, because she was very youthful looking. But her son said to me after, he says, you've made her very happy. And that was sincerity. And again, another situation occurred where one of the ladies who's running the charity came with a daughter and wanted a daughter in the picture. And we are having a meditation or spiritual class, which I'm going to give next Friday at one of their homes, and there's a group of people coming. And a daughter who could speak English, she was about 14, said, "You've made my mother very happy." Now, when I hear words like that, and this is all deriving from the painting and the message that's being given with it, there's got to be something that's actually striking a chord where people are now feeling what it is. Yesterday I had two separate people come and talk about the energy coming from the painting. And this chap said it's because of the children. He says they're untouched by society's false values and boundaries which are drawn. He says this is what the energy is coming from, the children. And this was again related further in the day about the energy coming from the painting. It's not new, but what I'm saying is it is increasing with vocal support in every way. So really, with all these children that are appearing, it does seem to have quite a significance the way it's now going. But again, I have to retain that bottom section to put the all-important part of the painting together. So with that, I'm going to end today. This is Saturday afternoon. It's just turned 3:30, and we've been invited to a barbecue somewhere quite a way away. But again, it was an invitation with good thoughts, and so we're going to try and enjoy the day, which will make
a welcome relief from me to have a few hours respite and see what happens. So with that, I'm going to say good night and thank you for watching.